We have, how many people? 83 people in the live chat. Here we go, the game starts. Flipper in blue against Malmö in white.
What? Toronto.
Jump in. And I have Kim with me. Hello, Kim.
Hi.
Hi. So we're in the game, and Flipper is in blue, and Malmö Triton in white. Do you know these teams?
Yes, I do.
For which team? Please introduce yourself, Kim. People might know me, but they haven't heard your voice yet. So please introduce yourself.
Hello, I'm Kim. I'm Dutch. I'm from the Netherlands, and I played a lot of underwater hockey. I was really great. You can say that, right?
Yes, you can say that, absolutely. We're an open community, as you know.
Then I moved to Sweden, and I started playing underwater rugby. So obviously, I'm in this game for Triton. Even though I normally don't root for them, because they're still the enemy. And from Flipper, I don't know that much, but I meet some of the guys sometimes at the Malmö Triton summer camp. So let's see if they have learned something, and if they can beat the Triton camp here, the Triton team here.
Okay, people are watching. Let's see, from California, there was one that's very nice watching from playing from with Bogota Castores. And
Flipper is preparing for an attack.
Yes,
just hanging in the corner.
I think Flipper is, in my opinion, the stronger team here in this game. But let's see what Triton has in store. Flipper is stuck in on the close side of the corner of the Triton basket and is pushing hard, and already they position players all around. But the forging attack of Malmö is doing a good job to keep them away from the basket. But yesterday I took pictures of the Flipper team, and they are, well, they're big. They're really beasts, man. So really big guys.
And they're very, you know, I asked them, like, are you going to win this cup? And they said, well, we'll see. They didn't say.
Well,
hell yeah.
I think they're pretty self-confident. So, Triton is going into the basket.
That's not a... You should first remove the goalie before you try to put the ball
in
the goal.
Or you can push the goalie with the ball into the basket.
But he was definitely not putting enough power in that.
No, that's true. And Flipper is back. And here we see the player waiting on the open side, ready to receive the goal, but didn't manage. And the second one came in, and this is a chance, yes.
Yes.
Very well done. And that's exactly the attack again came from the close side. Ball was passed to the open side, and the player was all alone, undisturbed. And he could work over the head, under the head of the goalkeeper, and push the ball into the basket.
With a lot of power, and you saw his distinction, I'm gonna score.
Yes, yeah, absolutely. Those who position on this, the others are just working for them, waiting on the other side, who go in for the kill. And now...
I saw some hugging there.
No, there was no, I don't think so. Friendly hugging?
Friendly hugging.
Friendly hugging, wow.
You know, they are neighbors, Flipper and Malmö.
They are,
they
are.
There's a bridge in between them.
That doesn't mean there has to be a lot of love.
So something happened, and I still didn't really get the hang of all the.
Yeah, this is a
signs.
Call from the referees. It's a free throw against Flipper, and Flipper, in naturally, as far as I know them from the Champions Cup, they are very, very good defenders. So normally, if they play against a stronger team, they duck in on their side, and then they go for the counter attack and go through with force and try to score in the first counter attack. But in this case, they're a little bit in the upper hand against Malmö Triton and play a bit more open as I know them. Here comes the Malmö team from the close side.
Let's see if they can do the same thing that Flipper did before, and Flipper is swimming it out again.
Forechecking in the middle, and the Flippers already made it to the other side and are positioning themselves in the corner of the pool.
And I see that Malmö is preparing for defense.
So the thing is, what Malmö has to do is to interrupt the attack play of Flipper by forechecking. Call from the referee, pushing without ball, pushing, that's a sign the referee we see is making, pushing without ball, free throw against Flipper.
A fun fact here, in hockey we use the same signals, but they mean something totally different.
Oh, interesting. What does it mean if you see the pushing sign?
We don't have the pushing sign.
Okay. And Malmö is in attack again, and now there is a Malmö player waiting on the open side to return the favor. Flipper just scored.
What you can see super nicely here is when the goalie switches, they swim nicely out to set
to join in
and to try to get this counterattack going. They don't go up, they go out. And Flipper is on the middle field swimming towards the goal.
We're missing the center camera, so we don't have a very good view on the in the middle of the pool.
But we all know what's happening there. They're fighting over the ball.
Yeah, probably. We're on the surface having a cluster, and the Flipper player is free out. And
really
this is
nice ball control here.
Yeah, but this is exactly what Malmö has to do. They have to interrupt the attacks of Flipper before they happen, because if these big guys are too close to the basket and have a chance to work on the goalkeeper, it's almost impossible to stop them. So Flipper has Malmö has to interrupt the game by forechecking way before the Flipper guys can touch the basket. And we have counterattack. The pass was lost between the two players. The one in front didn't see it quite right.
Which was a shame, because it was a good chance to
make a good run
on this goal. Something is happening at the surface, which we also don't see right now.
Guess we have a cluster on the surface, the fighting for the ball. Now the ball is free, again a Flipper counterattack. This is dangerous, always a super dangerous situation if they have a chance to counter through and touch the basket of Malmö Triton. Here they are, two of the three Flipper player are going in on the basket. One is above and two are left and right. Now the ball is free, second wave comes in. The defense is ready, and there's one player waiting from Flipper on the close side.
And the other person is disturbing the goalie.
Ball is free, almost in the hands of the goalkeeper. And here's Malmö Triton, very well defended against the attack of three Flipper players who came in with a lot of speed. Again, ball is dropping down in the hands of a Flipper player, and the one right in front of the basket didn't receive the ball well. And they start to build up their attack pattern from the corner, and the ball was pushed out of the hand of the Flipper player, fell down, but still in possession of Flipper. And again, Malmö starts its forechecking, trying to stop the Flipper players from getting close to the basket. But if you concentrate too much on the forechecking, on defending, you have gaps in the defense, and the Flipper player can position themselves. So if they break through the forechecking of Malmö, they have a chance to pass through the one waiting at the basket.
Unless they have an extremely good rolling and the forechecking is only done by the attackers.
Yep. And but another wave, and this
goal
is dangerous. Yeah,
yeah, dangerous.
There is a Flipper player with no defense in between, and Malmö Triton is now
mentally.
Malmö is defending the goal now, really with
their
teeth.
Definitely not a goalie, but he is taking over a lot of space.
Yeah, and a
good
score.
But unfortunately for Malmö.
You see this this moment when the pressure starts to be too heavy and the defense starts to dissolve, and this happened in this moment, and the guy in front of you, like you said, probably wasn't a goalie, but he tried to defend as a defender and played the goalie role, but he wasn't good enough in this moment to stop the Flipper player, and they scored. So it's a 2-0 here now.
Personally, I still have a lot of trust in Malmö. I hope they come with a surprising Mälaren goal. But with this ball handling, they need to step a bit up their game.
We're now at the Flipper basket. and the Malmö Triton players try to duck in around the basket. There's one player almost wrapped around the basket of Flipper, and he tried to do the Merla probably, but the defense of Flipper is very experienced and probably one of the best defenses we have here. Game over in the first half.
So this sign actually means
if the crossed hands. Ah, okay.
So I always get so confused when I'm like, how do you mean?
That's interesting. We have the same signs with a different meaning.
Yes.
Didn't know that. I once commentated a hockey game, but I didn't get it really. I was just surprised how tough it was. I always thought it's don't touch a sport, but it's very physical to play hockey.
I actually became more physical now that I play rugby, and I went back to hockey once. I started using techniques that, you know, are actually not allowed, but if the referee doesn't see it, you're still allowed to do it.
So we have a 3-minute break in between the games. And Malmö Triton, I guess they cannot be happy with their game. They pretty much were overrun by Flipper, which is not that big surprise. I was putting Flipper in the superior team spot here in this game. And they have a formidable defense, which they use against tougher teams, just to dug in around themselves, build a fortress all around their basket, and then wait for the attack to come to strip the ball out of the hands of the attacker, and then go for a counterattack with force and score, go back again and in defense and keep everything the way they can. So checking the live stream.
Someone is trying to go more up and down.
Yeah, we have a comment here in the live stream from Jörn Christopherson. Yeah, I know Flipper and Malmö know each other pretty well. And he's writing here, they did a lot of training matches, and all of these matches were won by Flipper.
Maybe that's also a mental state for Malmö, knowing that.
There's a question, where in the Netherlands you play hockey?
I played hockey in Breda. The team is called Argonauta. But I also played in Dordrecht with OSCD. And I'm actually, now that I'm live commentating, can ruin the rumor that we do not have underwater rugby in the Netherlands, because we do.
Oh, I didn't know that.
No,
never
I figured
heard
it
about
out
a team.
Last week, and there's one team, I already forgot the name of the team, but there's one team of like 10 guys that is playing underwater rugby in the Netherlands. So let's see if they can step up their game and maybe eventually come here.
That would be nice. So we have Christian Schaefer asking, who is commentating with Volo?
We met in Oslo, and I played there once. I was so impressed by how Akeren had their practice. But the game started, so
and back in the game,
that.
We changed the sides, and Flipper is now on the left side in blue, still in blue, and Malmö Triton in white. And you can see Malmö Triton, their coach would have told them, Andreas Bergholz would have told them, we have to step up here and go in harder on the defense of Flipper. But once again, Flipper managed to strip the ball out of the hands of the Triton players, and they go for a fast counterattack to the Malmö Triton basket. Forechecking by Malmö is quite good. The Flipper player have difficulties breaking through, but now they reach the basket, and there's already the ball carrier on the open side.
And a nice second wave starts.
And Malmö Triton try to establish their defense. There is a player waiting on the open side. That's the game they play. Going in on the close side with a lot of push and waiting for the ball carrier to bring the ball to the other side. Free throw against Malmö Triton.
And Flipper is already down.
Flipper tried to steal the defense from Malmö, didn't succeed here. And again, attack from the close side. And the ball is in the corner. But Flipper is quite dynamic here, trying to open up the space, and there's always a Flipper player trying to deal away the defense and the perimeter around the basket. Now Malmö Triton is stripped the ball out of the hands of the Flipper player. Back, ball is back to Flipper. That's an intense forechecking here in the middle of the pool. Both teams are not giving an inch to the other team. Two Malmö players attacking a Flipper player, and it's back and forth between the two teams. The ball is really loose. None of the teams can get a good hold of the ball, but now we are back in the close side, and Flipper tries to establish their game from the corner of the pool. But the forechecking of Malmö is super intense, and it keeps them busy, so they cannot start their attack
on
the basket.
They are stealing the goal.
And there's one player from Flipper stealing the basket from Malmö Triton, but the goalkeeper came in time, and now we have a huge cluster around the Flipper basket. And what comes out? A Triton player with the ball going for counterattack. The ball was deflected by himself, by a Triton player, in the hands of a Flipper player. And we're back again in the middle of the pool. Call from a referee, pushing without ball, holding without ball. Free throw against Malmö Triton.
You saw that they stole the goal earlier.
Yes.
This is very obvious. What would you say?
Well,
how do you make a stealing goal an actual goal?
Well, you just have to wait there, and the goalkeeper from the other team has to cover you. But in the moment the attack comes, you just move a little bit and open up a little space, so there is no resistance for the attacker. Mm. So you just have to stay long enough down to be able to wait for the attack.
So a missed chance for Flipper.
Yeah, and an attack again from the close side. The Malmö defense was there in time, but very, really, really in the last second before the attack happened.
And they left with the ball, trying to come closer to the goal of Flipper. But Flipper is also defending heavily here. As you said before, no centimeter is given for free.
And the ball was outside of the playing area. Free throw against Malmö from the middle of the pool.
Which is a shame, because they broke out.
Yeah.
But if you swim out, you
lose
the ball.
But that's tactic. You can just push out the ball carrier out of the playing area, so you get the free throw for yourself. It's a tactical foul.
Things you learn at Champions Cup.
Yeah, things you learn.
So if you're not here yet, take this with you so you can come here next year.
And again, Flipper is attacking, still leading 2-0 against Malmö Triton in white, and Flipper is playing blue. Ball is loose right in front of the basket, and Malmö tries to break through, but the forechecking, the defensive forechecking from Flipper starts at the Malmö basket. And this is a good attack. Now Flipper is a little bit under pressure and late on the basket, and Malmö tries to push from the close side into the goalkeeper, but tackled away to the surface. And
they are ready to doing the Swedish Mälaren if they get the ball in time. But Flipper is defending very well. In the meantime, we have a question from the audience. You mentioned that one of the teams had the best defense. What makes them so good?
Well, they're very cool playing. This is Flipper again,
yes,
attacking from the open side. And this is, if you have enough player around the basket, and the defenders don't know where the ball is, so when they pass it really fast between them, it's easier for them to work on the goalkeeper when he doesn't know where the ball is, and then push really hard. Good morning, everybody.
Hi.
Well, the defense of Flipper, they're very... Hey, Lorena, and this is Kim with me. Hello, Kim.
I'm having a bad hair day, by the way.
Again. Well, the defense of Flipper, they are really cool in defense. They're very experienced, and you need the forecheckers fill in the gaps that probably create by blocking from the other team. So the good defense is if you don't leave any gaps in your defense, and if the defender right in front of the basket is in position but doesn't react this much to the movements around, just covers enough area, and the forechecking is doing the rest, keeping the attacks from above the goalkeeper away and the attacks from the open side where probably the defender is blocked. And this is a good game for Flipper. Defending is really their strong side.
Yeah, try to focus on that the next time that they are under attack. They are so relaxed. They're just looking like it's a no-gamer for them. But in the meantime, they're trying to attack on the Triton goal. I have the feeling they're taking it a little bit easier, waiting for the gap to just swim to the goal and punch the ball in. I can't imagine that Triton is not getting tired of that much forechecking and swimming out, but still trying to keep control of their own goal.
Yeah. Like I said, Malmö has to keep Flipper away before they are able to reach the basket. Caught from the referee, holding without ball, and it's a free throw against Flipper. Last year we saw Flipper playing a lot like the style. They just dug in, for example, against the Orcas. They dug in on their own side, built their defense, and just kept everything away. And then in the last second, they got a ball and counterattacked really fast with a lot of force with three players, and then they scored, and the rest of the game they just defended. Mm. And they kept it like that. So we have a timeout. We don't see who
for
took
the
timeout.
White team. So Triton is taking a timeout. Maybe they're trying to get up with a master plan to punch in one more goal.
Well, they also can play it cool here because they are leading 3-0, and Flipper is playing blue, and Malmö Triton is playing in white. And Triton has really a hard time. They're doing a good job forechecking and stopping the building up the attack patterns of Flipper, but in the end there is always a Flipper player more. It looks like there's a Flipper player more waiting at the Malmö Triton basket and going in.
I'm reading the comments, and we need to admit that my Swedish is not as fluent, so
well, it's probably better than mine. We call it Merla. The Merla, when you wrap around with a stomach to the basket and you push the goalkeeper up with your knee and an arm, an elbow, and he doesn't know from where the ball will be put inside. We saw this very perfection made by the Colombian U24 female team in the penalties against Germany on the World Championship for Juniors in Oberhausen last week.
But I still think it's not a very catchy name.
Well, it's a shrimp. It's a shrimp, isn't it, Merla?
I thought it was the scissor move.
Yeah, but it's a shrimp. It's the idea. Isn't the Merla a shrimp kind of thing that just wraps around something? Think that.
I associate it with the water that is around Stockholm, which is called Merlaren. But
okay.
Until so far, my Swedish knowledge.
Okay, back again. Now Malmö is attacking. They have to step up. Still in the first half here, and one minute left. Not sure if the time display is right.
But I also think we're not on the first half anymore.
True, they changed. Well,
yes.
I'm really not.
It's Saturday morning also for us. But you're doing a great job commentating all of the games. So I'm very impressed with that.
Well, it's a lot of fun, but it really blurs. If you only talk, you try to relate what you see. It really, the games blur into each other.
Like the blur we see right now.
Yeah,
who
is a
basket,
holding the ball? Basket going up on the surface right above the Flipper basket. And this normally is a dangerous situation for the basket on above which the cluster is, because the ball drops down, and if the teams are awake, you can have easily a very fast attack that happens really fast. Call from the referee on the surface.
I once accidentally scored while we scrummed up with the whole goal, and I dropped the ball and it accidentally fell.
Wow.
In the goal. Yes.
Congratulations.
That's how you score. Yes.
Well done.
A newbie not knowing what she was doing.
Free throw for Flipper. No, end of the game. End of the game. Sorry.
So we ended up with 3-0 for Flipper. They did a really good job. Malmö did a really good job trying to get as little goals against them by keeping them far out of their own goal zone. But unfortunately, they let three goals in. The first one was really a nice heavy attack, where you can see that with power you can actually put a goal in.
So the next game coming up is Riksu against Budweis. This will be an interesting...
This will be an interesting game, is what he was trying to say.
Yeah, before Lorena interrupted me, she tried to say something too. And I'm not fully awake, and I'm not able to multitask. And when I'm not fully awake and not able to multitask, I'm a little bit overloaded here. Okay.
I'm just wondering, do you think Flipper will win the whole thing?
I'm sure they are up for it. They're one of the top teams with Riksu, with Bamberg, with the Orcas from Colombia. Mm-hmm. Definitely one of the teams that are able to win this Champions Cup this year. Difficult to say. The margins are very, very thin between those top teams.
So it will be really interesting to see the road to the finals, who is actually going to take it home. And that's so exciting about this year, that you don't know who's going to win at all.
Yet in the last years, and this is the first year for 7 years, I think, that Molde is not playing. And for 10 years they played at the Champions Cup, but for 7 years they dominated in a row by winning the Champions Cup. And so everybody knew Molde will be in the finals. But this year, and last year it was Riksu winning, but this year it's like an open game. Riksu is definitely able to defend their title, but the other teams will step up, and Flipper is one of the candidates that is for sure able to challenge Riksu here. So this will be an interesting game. The next one is Budweis in... let me see. Budweis in white against Riksu in blue. Riksu! We hear the Riksu calls. And sadly, Tom Holmberg cannot play because he had a MMA fight and is injured. But I'm sure in his thoughts, he is with his game.
It can help the team with the spirit that he is not being able to play because of an injury. So they maybe feel like they need to step up their own game in order to gain his loss.
Always, if you're a tight team with a history, the family feeling, and you're missing a key player, it's always difficult to fill these gaps. If you're used to play with a special player together in a team, if he's not in the water, it's like a hole in a structure.
But is he on the side?
He's here, yes.
Yes,
Tom Holmberg is here.
That if he will start screaming to his team, they know how much.
Yesterday he told me they told him to shut up.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's an interesting, you know.
Well, he was giving them advices, so.
Was the advice put the ball in the goal?
Yes, Christian, I bring your book, so you can get it whenever you want. I'm here in the commentator box, and I have the book you asked me to bring you. I have it with me. So again, the next game is an interesting one. We see the experienced team from Budweis, Czech Republic, in white against the still title holder of the Champions Cup, Riksu from Finland. And Tom Holmberg yesterday told me they always have fun playing. For them it's just like when the other teams are super tensed, they enjoy just the game. For them underwater rugby is like dancing. Reminds me a little bit what the Colombians told me and how the Colombians played.
So if you're not following us on Instagram or Facebook yet, we're updating all the scores as we go.
Thank you for that, Kim. That's really great work you and the social media team do. It's amazing how you can broaden the inside view if you use all the channels that are available. And in the last years we didn't have the manpower, now we have the women power to do it.
Hell yeah.
And it's really great work, and to have also the Graz team here who step in and just broad and everything we can offer to the audiences is amazing.
So if you follow us on Instagram, you can also let us know what you would like to see besides the scoring. Because of course we know you're interested in the scores, but maybe you also want to know what's above the water going on. I've seen people running outside doing their warm-up.
Yes, yes, it's super interesting, and it would